up? How you doing, brother? You got a question? Yeah. How you doing? What's your name, bro? What's your name, man? How you doing?
How you doing?
All right, all right.
I believe in God.
Okay.
I believe in man, and I believe in every color, every nation, and this and that, and whatnot. And I believe under all these different tribes or whatsoever it is, no matter what color, blonde hair, straight hair, whatsoever, it had to be a creator.
Right, that's true. That's very true.
Right? Now, I don't believe that God is concerned about color.
You're not? You don't think so?
I don't think so.
So you don't think he's concerned about?
So what I'm saying to you, let me be specific.
Yeah.
If God was created about color, and there have to be a leader, why he made blonde hair? Why he made so many different nations with so many different?
All right. First of all, I'm gonna show you something about what we're supposed to do.
Let me ask my question.
2 Ezra 6:54.
Let me ask my question.
Now here's what I want you to see.
I want you to understand.
When
I
ask a question, we're going to answer with the word of God.
All right. What I'm saying to you, if he made so many different nations, so many different people, and so many different things, and there's supposed to be one God to care about all, why are so many people trying to paint so many different pictures when one person's supposed to run all?
Okay.
The Bible tells me that no man...
2 Ezra 6:54. Let's hear what God says. Because guess what I want you to see? We didn't come out here to learn. We came out here to teach.
That's right.
We are already learned men. This is what I want you to understand. Read.
And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him come we all.
So we all come from Adam. Do you agree?
As far as you know.
Okay? Because Adam was the first man, so we all come from Adam. That's what. See, now here's the thing. You love God, but the word of God just said, come we all. Read.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen.
Now, it says, we all come from Adam, but there's a people whom God has chosen. So there's a distinction in that verse.
Who are they? Israelites?
My man. Who are they is the million-dollar question. Isaiah 44:1. You're going to come back here. Isaiah 44:1. Like I showed you. Listen, you're going to ask the question, and we're going to answer from the word of God. Wait.
The book of Isaiah 44:1. Uh-huh. Yet now hear, O Jacob, my servant, and Israel, whom I have chosen.
We understand that Israel is a chosen people. But the people in Israel, they are black. They are black people, but they are straight.
Hey, in your patience possess ye your soul.
That's right.
Because we're not done answering the first question yet. We're going to get to who those devils in Israel are. Because Israel is a man before it was a land. Israel had sons, and we are the descendants of those 12 sons.
So what you're
Go back to 2 Ezra. What God is telling you. I didn't tell you anything. God is going to tell you. 2 Ezra 6.
The book of 2 Ezra 6:55. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sake.
So the chosen that we just read, God made the world for their sakes. God made this entire world for the Israelites. You should not be a servant in your world, but because of your sin, because of the sins of our people, we are now servants this day.
As for the other people
who are not of the chosen, who are not Israelites, read,
which also come of Adam.
They come from Adam too. Read.
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
Bring it out.
You want me to ask some more questions? Because I fear my question is still unanswered.
So the people, you said God loves all, but the Bible just said the other people from Adam who aren't Israelites are nothing.
Let me ask you a question.
Do you acknowledge what we just answered?
Do you believe that God came down to get those that understand or those that don't understand?
Hold on a second. He said, did God come down to get those who understand or those who don't understand? The question is, understand what?
Understanding the truth.
What's the truth?
What is the truth? That's
good
the
question. See, that's wrong. I want sincere questions like that. Psalms 119:142.
Bring it out.
Let's see. Because the answer came. He ask, what about the other people that God loves all, is what you said. But we just proved, God said the rest of the people who are not Israelites are absolutely nothing.
What it said, that those that don't follow and don't believe in the truth.
The book of Psalms, chapter 119 and verse 142. He said, God is not prejudiced. Stick around. You're going to find out you've been taught lies, my brother.
Hey.
Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth.
What's the truth?
And thy law is the truth. The laws of God are the truth.
How do you get it if it's not implemented?
Hold on. What do you think we're out here doing today? Giving our people the laws of God, but you don't want it. You want the white man's yoke around your neck called the Christian cross.
It still boils down to the same question. He's here to teach those that don't know. If you don't know, he's not here for those that do know and follow in the Lord.
Okay.
And live it. He's here to teach those and bring those into the fold that do know.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Give me Leviticus 21 and 5. Because the laws of God are true.
I love everybody. I don't hate no one. But I'm here to show my wisdom. But if you're here to understand the wisdom of what none don't believe, that's your choice.
Did you hear us say to hate anybody?
That's the way I see life.
Wait a minute. He said he's not here to hate anybody. Have we taught that?
Nope.
You haven't heard that, right? So what it is Christianity is so ingrained in their head, you can't stand to see brothers that look like you come to the island and stand up for you. We here for you. You don't tell a white man in a Christian church about nothing. You sit there and you listen. But when it comes to people that look like you, Christ look like you, prophets look like you, Moses look like you, God looks like you, that's when you got a problem. Because you hate yourself. Read that thing. The book of Leviticus, chapter 21 and verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard. You want some truth? Stop shaving off your beard. Give me Habakkuk 2 and 18. You want some truth? We're going to give you some truth.
Bring it out.
Let's see what God says.
I'm highly intelligent, but don't tell me.
Don't tell me and don't look at me like that.
Don't even try to do that, brother.
Here's what I can tell you why.
From what you're saying, I can see a subliminal message. What's the subliminal message? From the way you look at me and what I'm saying.
Hold on a second. Okay, very. I like the book. He said, don't entertain him. But read. The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2 and verse 18. What profit if they? You know what you see? The same sensitive brothers we have in the States is the same sensitive brothers we got on the island. You see that? Let brothers talk to you like a man. I see what you're trying to say subliminally. Listen, ain't no subliminal messages here. The word of God is plain, brother. It is plain as day. It's that you don't want it. You trust in oppression. Read. The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 18. What profit if the graven image? So what profit is in the graven image? Read. That the maker thereof have graven it. The molten image and a teacher of lies. So you have a molten image around your neck. You have a molten image that God never told you to wear. You have a molten image that you have exalted to wear on the outside of your clothing as if it signifies righteousness. But the Bible says that shows us that you've been taught lies, brother. Let's see what God says again.
A teacher of what? A teacher of lies.
Your cross is a teacher of lies, man. So we're here to show you that you've been lied to, brother. Because you know what I've heard the whole time he was here? I think. I believe. Listen, we went into slavery because of what we think. We're on the bottom because of what we think. It's not about what we think. It's about what God says. That's what we have to defer back to. It ain't about what we think. We're not out here teaching what we think. We're teaching you what God says. That's it.
Who is God?
That's it.
And who is your God?
Okay, first finish that real quick. That the maker of his work trusted therein to make them idols. So he said, who's God, right? Let's go to Deuteronomy 28. You need to listen too, brother. Don't put the Mason stuff on. You need to listen to.
Cap on, you ignorant.
Deuteronomy chapter 28.
Secret order.
Start at verse 1.
Life ain't secret.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. So now, our God told the Israelites, the 12 tribes, if you hearken to the word of God, he'll put the nation of Israel above all people on the face of the earth. So now, what do you think about the island of Bahamas? Are all people on the top or the bottom?
I think the garden of the Bahamas is the garden of the
earth. I'm talking to you right here, brother.
You ain't want to talk to me.
You said we're on top?
Yeah, because, but honestly, if I put it to you, the way the mindset in the Bahamas, it's on a lower level.
Okay.
We're already set on the top.
No, I didn't ask you that. I'm asking you, are we on the top or on the bottom?
I'm talking mental-wise.
We are on the bottom.
Thank you, brother. We got one honest brother out here. That's it. We on the daggone bottom. That's it.
I'm talking mentally, though.
Listen.
I'm speaking mentally.
I'm saying mentally and physically. Because you have to go. Listen, those big mansions in the hills, is it all people in them?
Hell no.
Wait a minute. So what are we talking about?
You want to be rich?
Read.
You want to have all those
15.
I don't want to be rich. I just want to be able to
maintain. But it shall come to pass. Did any of y'all say y'all want to be rich?
Nobody. Huh? So what you say?
Huh?
Nobody. What you measuring up your example of what you trying to explain?
Right. Read that again. But it shall come to pass if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. So all these curses, if you don't hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God and do all his commandments. So it's either blessings above all nations or cursed and be below all nations. So we fit the curses as a people.
Why?
Now, so your brother said true. Give me verse 48. Verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies. So one of the curses is you're going to serve your enemies. Guess what we serve our enemies for? Religion. You see that big cross around his neck? His enemy gave him that cross. The enemy taught him Christianity. You see, hey brother, you see the Freemasons? Your enemy taught you that, brother. That's what your enemy taught you.
You know what the cross stands for?
Therefore,
it's a medieval torture device.
It is a torture device, a Roman torture device. You are absolutely right. So now, that's just like if one of your family members get killed by a gun, right? Do you walk around with a gun around your neck?
Exactly.
Thank you, brother. Can you tell that brother there, please? Thank you. Read. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore, shalt thou serve. You know what? I'm gonna ignore that. Go ahead. Therefore, because we don't have enough time, we gotta go. This is about turn. Come on, go ahead. Therefore, shalt thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee. So the Lord sent enemies against us. And it says you're going to serve them. Go ahead. In hunger, when you want food, do we own any of the food plants here? Do we have all any of the ships?
It's all important.
No.
By who?
It's all imported by the people to bring here to us.
That's
to
not true.
Yes. No, we have people that grow here, but the majority of the restaurants. I work in hospitality.
In hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things. So anything you want, whether it's religion, whether it's food, whether it's clothing, the Bible says you must depend on your enemies for everything. That's what God says. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck. Now, brother, this goes back to what you said about mentally destroyed, right? Remember that? Now, read. Until he have destroyed thee. Now, God says the children of Israel were going to have yokes of iron upon their necks until you have been destroyed.
Right.
Ah.
You know there's white slavery right now, too, right?
Hey. Can you show me that? Now it comes to walk away. Hey, give me 1 Thessalonians 5:21. He said, you know there's white slavery? Okay, so here's what God says.
They don't kidnap white little children.
He said kidnap.
Send them all over the world.
And then I want, what's that, Daniel 12, Daniel 11, Daniel 11 and 9.
9-11.
Thank you. Read that. The book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 8. That's what that cross around his neck does. It makes you care about other people more than your own.
Hey!
brother sees, he sees brothers travel from far to come and teach him and those on his island. And he's worried about white children going, man, to hell with that. We're on the bottom, man. We on the bottom suffering. Man, read that thing, man. I bring the first Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 21. So you said there's white slavery.
You only care
the Bible
about
says,
go
the
ahead.
Bible, no, we care about Bali, the 12 tribes of Israel. No, we are so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. That's who we care about.
That's right.
Read that again. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 21. Prove a thing.
So there's white slavery? Prove it. Prove it. Daniel 9:11. Read the book of Daniel, chapter 9, verse 11. Yea, all Israel have transgressed thy law, even by departing, that they may not obey thy voice. Therefore the curse is brought upon us.
We just read about the curses, right? Yeah. One of them, we're going to have yokes of iron around your neck until we are destroyed as a people. Right?
Read.
And the oath that is written in the law of Moses.
So the oath is, God says, if you hearken to my voice, do my commandments, you'll be above all nations. The other part of that oath is, if you don't, you'll be cursed. You understand that? So the oath was given to Moses to tell the children of Israel. Go ahead.
Because we have sinned against him.
So why did these curses come upon us?
Because we have sinned against him.
It's because of our sins while we suffer today.
And he have confirmed his words, which he spake against us and against our judges that judge us, by bringing upon us a great evil.
So what was brought upon us? A great evil. What was more evil than this? Your sons and daughters being fed to alligators. Your daughters being raped. Your sons being raped. Your wife being raped. You being raped. Being forced. Your hands were cut off if you didn't bring back enough sugar cane. If you didn't bring back enough precious metals. Who suffered like we suffered? Nobody. Read.
For under the whole heaven, the Bible says, under the entire heaven, no matter what land you're in, have not been done as have been done upon Jerusalem.
Wait a minute. Nobody on the planet has suffered more than the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Nobody. So you think we out here to raise up the person who had us in slavery?
No.
They are controlling everything.
Hey.
Give me Isaiah 61:1.
Bring it out.
Our people are burnt out.
That's right.
You are burnt out. You want the daggone bottom and you worried about the other nation.
They never seen the treatment of God. We are not black men, we are the Israelites.
Daniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.